Assalamu alaikum and welcome back. Now we are going to look at, insha'Allah ta'ala, the steps of the salah in light of that prophetic hadith, pray as you have seen me praying. Now, the prayer consists of units, and these units are known as raka'at, the singular being raka'ah. And every salah has a number of units. So the first prayer of the day, fajr, consists of two raka'at. The second prayer, the midday prayer, the dhuhr prayer, consists of four raka'at. The third prayer of the day, the asr prayer, consists of four raka'at. The maghrib prayer, that is the prayer after the sun sets, is three raka'at. And the final prayer of the day, the isha, consists of four raka'at. So now, let's begin to look at the steps of the salah and how to perform the salah as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. Now let's begin. First of all, the person who is praying will begin by raising his hands up to his shoulders or in line with his ears. Whilst he is doing so, he says, Allahu Akbar. Next, he places his right hand over his left hand and he begins with the opening supplication of the prayer. Now, the opening supplication is optional and this will be discussed in a further presentation. Now, after he has completed the opening supplication, he begins with the isti'adha. And the isti'adha is saying, A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. This is to be said at the beginning of the salah. Next, he says the basmala. And the basmala is saying, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Now, he will begin reciting Suratul Fatiha. This is the opening surah of the Quran, the first chapter of the Quran. Suratul Fatiha. And Suratul Fatiha should be perfected. And you must ensure that you have a scholar or a teacher check your Suratul Fatiha. Because Suratul Fatiha is one of the pillars, it is one of the arkan, it is one of the main elements to salah. So this is why it is important, and the one praying will be saying this a minimum of 17 times in the day and night. Suratul Fatiha. Let's begin. So we said we start with the isti'adha. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Then the basmala. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And now we begin with the words of Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Malik Yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين إهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Now after you say ولا الضالين, you say آمين. Next, after reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, you will recite a surah or a chapter or parts of a chapter from the Qur'an. So for example, let us take the 112th surah from the Qur'an, which is Surah Al-Ikhlas. So now that you've finished Al-Fatiha, you've said Ameen, now you are going to begin again with the Basmala, with the Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Then the surah. So for example, we'll say, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Wa lam yakun lahu kufuwan ahad. Okay, now that you've completed your chapter, as we just did with Surah Al-Ikhlas, you are now ready to go into the ruku' position. That is the bowing position. Now what you need to do here is, as you are going down, first of all, you are going to raise your arms. You are going to raise your arms in line with your shoulders or in line with your ears. And as you are doing so, you begin to say, Allahu Akbar, and you are now entering into the ruku', the bowing position. Now, in this position, you must ensure that your back is straight. So that if I was, for example, to place a cup of water on your back, you must ensure that no drops will be coming out of that cup. You must also ensure that you are gripping your knees. So not with the fingers all together, nor are they stretched out, but just a nice gripping of your knees. Now in this position, you are saying the words of remembrance related to this position, the ruku' position. And they are, Subhana Rabbiya al-Azim. Now you can say that a minimum of once, but it is preferable to say it more than once, and in many cases you will find yourself saying it three times. Subhana Rabbiya al-Azim, Subhana Rabbiya al-Azim, Subhana Rabbiya al-Azim. Now you are ready to go back up into the standing position. Coming up from the ruku' position, you will say, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ whilst raising your arms. Then you will follow this up by saying, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ. So now you should be standing upright and with your arms by your side. Now you are ready to enter the sujood position, the prostration position. Now this is a very special position, so pay attention here. Now here, let's begin with the sujood position and by saying Allahu Akbar. And now you should be entering the sujood position. In the sujood position, you need to ensure that you are prostrating on seven bones, as indicated by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now these seven points are the forehead and the nose, that constitutes one point, the palms of your two hands, your two knees, and your two feet. Now with regards to your palms, the fingers must be together facing the Qibla. Now also what you need to keep in mind in this position is that your elbows must be off the ground and your arms away from your body. Now, with the feet must be upright with the toes facing the Qibla also, just as your fingers are facing. So now your whole body is in this very beautiful position, the sujood position, and this is the closest. This is the closest time that you will be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now in this position, you will also now be reciting the words of remembrance related to this position of sujood, and that is Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Now the minimum is once, but you, most people, as we learn, say it three times. And if you say more, then this is permissible as well.